All right, you may be having corned beef and cabbage tomorrow night, maybe a little shepherd's pie. I think that's what we're having at our house. But what do you do for dessert on St. Patrick's Day? Susan Nye is joining us today with a great Irish dessert. Yeah. So what are you calling this?
Well, this isn't really an Irish dessert at all. It's an Italian dessert, affogato, but we're giving it an Irish accent by giving it a little shot of Irish whiskey.
Say it with an Irish accent.
No, I can't do that. I'll let you do that.
How about affogato or something? We'll try that.
So it's a very simple recipe. You can find it on my blog, and I've got as well, right there is a slow-braised Guinness lamb shank, which you can have for dinner, and then have this very quick dessert, which is probably one of the simplest things that you can do.
It's kind of a twist on an Irish coffee, I guess.
It is a twist on an Irish coffee. Okay. So all I do is give a couple of spoonfuls of very good vanilla ice cream. And the secret to this whole dish is you want to use good coffee and you want to use good good ice cream. And the coffee, you can't brew it as a cup of coffee, you have to brew it as espresso. So if you don't have, you don't have to go out and buy one of those big, massive fancy schmancy machines. All you need is a little coffee maker like this. They're under $20. You can get them in kitchen stores, online, and they come in lots of different sizes as well.
And how does it work? Because I've never used one of those.
All you do is pull it apart. You put water in the bottom, coffee in the middle, and it makes a nice, very strong espresso.
Okay.
So I just pour it in right on top of the ice cream.
And the stronger the better in this
case,
right?
And the stronger the better, yeah.
All right.
And then to make the Irish part, all I do is add a little bit of Irish whiskey.
And there you have it.
And there you have it. And it's really delicious. It's really fun. I suppose if you have kids at dinner, you might want to skip the Irish whiskey for them.
If you've got
if you've got older people at dinner, they're all going to say, "Oh no, coffee." You can use decaffeinated. That's all right, mm-hmm. but at the same time, you still have to use very good Italian espresso decaffeinated coffee. That works as well.
All right, coffee and dessert at one point. And now that recipe you mentioned, where can people find it?
So you can find everything on my blog, which is susannye.wordpress.com. Both the slow-braised lamb shanks, which you can spend the afternoon smelling in your house because they're absolutely wonderful, and then this, which you can put together in just about 3 minutes.
All right, Susan, thank you so much. And we'll be right back.